true. Right there. I'm sorry. Right there. And I was doing the exact same thing you guys are doing. Grinding out pieces and then having horrid nightmares of Mrs. Duke and her infamous red pen. And now I'm at the New Republic.
Hey, guys. Gloria, that necklace is you. As soon as I get this piece done. Horrible.
Let me guess. He's on you again about a redesign.
How is it? You hate it?
No, it's the worst thing I ever wrote. It's horrible. If you guys don't help me with it, I'm not even gonna send it in. Tomorrow, I may have to kill myself. I mean, the New York Times Magazine. Will you guys help me with it? Please? Thank you. I'm not. It's probably nothing. Send it to my voicemail, okay? Oh, and sweetie, Caitlin just told me that she needs a gift for 2 showers next week. You think you might have something for her?
I couldn't resist.
So you want to do this now?
Yeah, or? In a second. I just have to return a quick phone call.
I got you some gum.
If I were to throw a party where all we did was play Monopoly, would you guys come? Of course.
Hey, it's...
There are 16,800 magazines in this country, but only one calls itself the in-flight magazine of Air Force One. And that's the thrill of working at the New Republic. You're underpaid, the hours are brutal, but what you write gets read by people who matter. Presidents, lawmakers. Your work can actually influence public policy. That's an amazing privilege and a huge responsibility. I'm sorry, they don't want to hear the whole journalistic responsibility speech. Do you? You just want to know how to get your name in print, right? That sounds familiar. Okay. Let me take you through the life of your typical piece so you can see where some of the hurdles are. We'll use one I wrote last year about a bunch of young Republicans at a conservatives convention. Now, journalism is about pursuing the truth. And I would never encourage you to do anything sneaky or dishonest in pursuit of a story, such as assuming a phony identity.
I don't know, man. It seemed like a pretty good turnout to me. Dead.
On a story like that, your notes are crucial. You have to record everything you see and hear, every quote, every detail, all the way down to the mini bottles in the fridge.
Hey, Chuck. What are you working on? Young Republicans at the CPAC conference. Pretty standard stuff. Hotel ballrooms, boring speeches, chicken dinners. Which is why everybody spends their time in the suites upstairs committing felonies. Yeah, I went to one. The ballroom was empty. Every delegate under the age of 25 was up on the 5th floor getting loaded. Drugs, binge drinking, hookers. Gets pretty ugly. So is yours. Okay, well, I gotta get back to work. Have a good lunch.
Hold it. Have to give myself a demerit for poor scene setting. Let me explain. A year ago, Chuck Lane and I were peers. He hadn't become editor yet. Michael Kelly was editing the magazine then. Sorry, Mrs. Duke. I know how you feel about clarity.
It was the Cannon Building. You had it as Russell. I fixed it. I really liked it, Ames.
No, I really, really liked it. Yes, dear.
No, I'm not. It's probably nothing.
Could you send it to my voicemail, please?
Oh, and by the way, Glow. That lipstick is the bomb. Was it Midnight Mist? I really gotta stop doing that. All I do is give people more reasons to assume I'm gay. I mean, lately, it's everyone. Like the other night, I went out to dinner with this guy from the Post. I can't tell you, he made me promise. Anyway, we're walking around afterwards, talking about Medicare, for God's sakes. And then the next thing I know, we're standing on the corner of 18th and T. And he somehow managed to slip his tongue down my throat. And I'm like, wait a minute, how'd this happen?
And neither did I.
Michael.
Of course.
Are you mad at me? Okay, my notes are at home. I can be back in 20 minutes. Is that too long?
I think so.
No, I'm sure. Why?
I saw them. No, there were little bottles of booze all over the room.
I'll get my notes.
I'm sorry. We're gonna have to finish this later.
No. Keen was right, Michael. I messed up. I made a huge error. I don't know what to say. If you want me to resign, I will. They don't have mini bars at the Omni Shoreham Hotel. I guess I just saw all those little bottles and I made an assumption, which I know we're never supposed to do. I'm really sorry. Those guys were drinking out of a rented refrigerator, a mini fridge.
Yeah. Well, yeah, of course.
Really?
You're not mad.
Do you want my notes?
Thanks, Michael. Thanks for backing me.
And she says, I didn't invite Vernon Jordan that evening because my guests of honor were girls from Smith College. Some of them were virgins, and I wanted to keep it that way. gosh, Alec, I don't know. I mean, you know, George is such a dignified publication. You wouldn't want to put in something that gossipy, would you? Of course I'm putting it in. The Fritos are running dangerously low. I'll be right back. Can't hide in here all night, Ames. You said you hated how the Diet Coke at parties was always at room temperature and how if you wanted to drink a cold, you'd have to put it on ice and then it would get too watery. Don't you remember?
Oh, thanks for coming.
Drive safe, Alec.
Associate editor at George.
I'm really not.
It's probably nothing.
What?
Are you mad at me?
I know. It's only nights. I wouldn't have to stop working or anything. I'm just gonna go put these down. I'll be right back. I told you, it's my parents, okay? They never shut up about it. If I don't go, they won't let me be a journalist anymore. You don't know how things go where I grew up, Caitlin. Okay, there are rules there. If your son's not a doctor or a lawyer, you keep your curtains closed.
You're right.
Not in Highland Park. I'm sorry. I know, it's ridiculous.
Stop apologizing for it.
I'm not. I can't. I'm sorry.